Aitika start with the name of Allah Almighty, who is the most gracious and the most merciful. Welcome to all of you in ICS Part 2. First of all, I want to say congratulations to all of you for your promotion. I hope you will give your best in the next session. Now, it's a time to start your computer book, in which your first chapter is about data basics. To understand this chapter, first of all, you must know about the term which is named as database. You can see some data sets on your screen. You must note that how these data files are collected in a sequence. The data in these files may be of any type, but when we collect this data in an organized form, then we can say that it is a database. Before defining the proper definition of database, first of all, we will discuss the following related concepts. These concepts are data, information, database, relational database, database management system, and database applications. Now we will discuss all these concepts one by one. In the first step, which is about data, we know that it is a collection of raw facts and figures. And when we apply any operation or any calculation on this data, then we can get the information. In other words, we can say that information is a processed form of data. By applying some process on data, we can get the information. And if we talk about database, we can say it is a collection of data sets or data files that is organized in a proper way. And in relational database, we can collect the record of related data sets or related entities. The entity may be anything, any file, or it may be any relation. So we can say in relational database, we can collect the record of related entities. And if we talk about database management system, it is a program that we can use for storing the database. We can save our data in database and we can also use it whenever we need it. Last is database applications. It tells us that where the database should be applicable. We can use database in any company or in any organization for saving our data. Now we will define database as it's a collection of organized information on a particular subject. It means that the related information can be collected on any particular subject. It is organized so that queries and reports based on the information can be readily performed. Some common examples of databases are telephone book and student records. Telephone book is an example of database because you can see that all the contact numbers in this book are written in an organized way, and we can use any number at any time whenever we need it. Similarly, you can see that in schools and colleges, the records of all the students are kept in a well-organized way so that we can use these records at any time. That's why database is also called record keeping system, because we can take this record at any time whenever we need it. Database is also called a computerized system whose purpose is to maintain information and to make that information available at any time. We can also take an example from the bank that may have separate files for its clients. These files may be about his saving account, it may be about his personal loan, or it may be about his biographic information. The client's database would include records from each of these files. In this way, we can get any type of information about any client very quickly and very easily. We also use database in different fields of our daily life. Like in a telephone book, all the contact numbers are arranged in a proper way. Similarly, in TV guide and in airline reservation system, all the records are maintained in an organized way. Database also provides some facilities to its users. Only the users of database can access these facilities. Some of these are given below. A user can add new blank files to the database. Only the database user can access this facility to add any new or any blank file to the database. He can also insert new data to the existing files. And if the user want to retrieve data from the existing files, then he can also retrieve his data. He can also update data. It means that if the user want to add any latest data into the existing file, then he can also update this data. If some data is unnecessary in the files, then he can also delete this data from the existing files. He can also remove some empty files from the database. In this way, a database user can enjoy these facilities. Now we will discuss the four components of database system. These components are data, hardware, software, and personnel. As we know that data is a collection of raw facts and figures, and processed form of data is information. By applying some process or some operations, data can be converted into information, and this is the most important component of database system. Next is hardware. Hardware can be defined as a physical parts of a computer that we can touch or that we can see. We can call it hardware, like monitor, keyboard, CPU. All these are the parts of the computer that we can touch or that we can see. So we can say that these are hardware components. And next is software. We can define software as a set of instructions given to the computer to solve a problem. Different types of software work in a computer, like system software and application software. System software enables the computer to work properly, and application software are used for specific purposes. Without this software, a computer cannot work, and so we can say that software is also the most important component of database system. And the last is personnels. These are the people. They may be programmers, they may be end users, or they may be database administrators. By using these four components, we can run a database system successfully. You must remember the term database because we will use this term in our next lectures. I hope you will give your best as a response. Thanks to all of you for your cooperation. Allah Hafiz.